Looks like they've been chained up.
Durval's a tinker. He probably experiments on them or strips them for parts.
Maybe I can use them to make some trouble. I'll go in first. Hold off until the fighting starts.
All right. We've got your back.
Release the machines!
It's the dirt, boys!
Yeah!
Duval's men. It's about to get ugly.
I hope so.
Intruders! Unleash the machines! Shoot their chains!
They called on the back!
Incoming!
Men. It's about to get away.
I hope so.
Intruders! Unleash the machines! Shoot their chains!
Here's a little something for you!
Oh!
Kills men.
Intruders! Unleash the machines! Shoot their chains!
For the Vanguard! No mercy!
Men. It's about to get ugly.
I hope so.
see how they like this! Just another day!
Thank you.
Well, that's done.
Drinks?
Oh, nice.
Thank you.
Nerval says you gotta eat dirt.
We have to get through.
They must use these to protect themselves from that awful sound.
Aaron? Durval tried to break me. Shows what he knows.
I should have been with you. Why didn't you come for me? I know I'm a useless trunk, but...
No, idiot. I got a message from Durval saying he wanted to parlay. I didn't come for you because I knew it was a trap. I couldn't let you get hurt. Just didn't think it'd be that good a trap. Thought I could take him out. No. Now listen. Durval's planning something big in Meridian. He said he'd force Avad to watch as the smoke darkens their precious sun. Your king needs you. No more playing around. You're gonna have to grow up fast.
I will. I promise.
You damn well better, little brother.
Ursa. No, no. Please. I won't let you down. I promise.
Aaron, I'm so sorry.
You've got to find Durval. But Meridian's a big place.
I'll look through his things. Maybe we can narrow it down. Such a strange device. It It's beautifully crafted. This machine's been picked apart with precision. Durval's records, maybe. Just notes about crafting. And a letter tucked between the pages. Lots of blaze. Headed to Meridian. If we find it, I'll bet we find Durval too. I think I found something that can help. Let's head back to the palace.
Go. I won't be long, but I need to tend to my sister.
Heavy. World's going white.
feet.
Always stay bright, always stay alert.
The sun shines on it.
I've sent a messenger to the claim to let everyone know.
If there's anything you or your clan need for her arrangements, you need but ask.
There'll be time for all of that later.
Aloy. I'm glad you're back. I'm at a loss about Ersa. To learn she lives, then lose that hope seems cruel.
She wouldn't want us to waste time talking. She'd want us to find Durval. She said he raved about smoke darkening the sun. Tell him what you found in his papers.
A letter. It mentioned a shipment of blaze being sent to a warehouse here. Only, it wasn't addressed to Durval. The name was Aeland Forgeman. Does that mean anything to you?
Sounds familiar. Yes, a landlord. The Oseram have been buying up buildings across the city, including one under that name. Let me think. It's by the edge of the mesa, near the temple. It used to be a shop, but it could serve as a warehouse. If Durval used the name as an alias to buy it, he might even be there now.
I'll round up my men.
I'll meet you there.
Erend, wait. Remember that no one hates Durval more than your own tribe. The clans would give up much to obtain him.
Take him alive? So you can haggle over him? You can't be serious!
Our security depends on keeping the peace. If the opportunity presents itself, take him alive. Consider that a command. Aloy, a moment, please. When we spoke, Aeryn didn't wish to dwell on the details of Ersa's death. Understandable, of course. But now that they've been left to my imagination, those details are all I can think about. You were there. Did she suffer?
She wasn't worried about her pain. She was worried about her brother. And she was worried about you.
Thank you, Aloy. I suppose I needed to know I was as much on her mind as she is on mine. Find Durval and bring him before me. He will answer for his crimes.
Every day, sleep like a rock every night.
We are paying for Sun King Jaron's sins.
I have a matter of grace and beauty I would like to just...
What did you want to talk about?
You were an outlander, no? An adventurer. I used to be one myself. I admit, I miss the beguiling colors of the wilds. Speaking of which, I wonder if you've come across a very special kind of flower. It's made of metal, like a machine. Other blossoms grow around them in amazing patterns. These gleaming beauties are very much in demand among my clients. If you bring me some, I have valuables to trade for them.
These metal flowers, what are they exactly?
No one knows, but some say they began sprouting 20 years ago when the machine started to go mad. Perhaps they grow from the tears of the sun, for he has many faces, does he not? Wrathful one day, cool and patient the next? Perhaps he weeps for our suffering when his anger breaks.
You said you were an adventurer.
Just so. The nobles of Meridian crave flowers for their balconies and gardens. So out I went, with bow and spear. I made my name by searching the wilds for the wildest blossoms. No bandit nor machine could keep me from those precious petals.
So what happened?
Love happened, my sweet. My paramour frets too much when I venture out. So now I collect flowers for those without such bonds.
Is it worth it? Being restrained like that?
Of course. Freedom is sweet. But the embrace of my beautiful Theridine is sweeter still. Ah, let us haggle over this beautiful bounty.
Till we meet again, my noble Nora. A moment of your time, Outlander?
Thank you.
You're looking for artifacts.
Yes, but I'm no profiteer. Sun King Avad has named me an envoy to the Banuk. I work on their behalf, looking for sacred relics to return to their homeland, Ben-Ur. I'm especially interested in wooden figures that are sometimes found near Banuk rock paintings. If you have any, I have valuables to trade for them.
Tell me more about these Banuk figures.
Simple wood sculptures made by Arnak, a legendary hunter who was exiled from Ban-Ur for killing his chief. He left the figures near painted stones in places that reminded him of his homeland. Later, his tribe declared him innocent. Now they see him as a kind of wandering hero and want those figures back. I do what I can to help him get them, including trade for them, if you have any.
You said the king named you an envoy to the Banuk?
Yes. I've been to Ban-Ur many times, and the Wirek chiefs trust me. I help them maintain diplomatic ties with Avad. Some say they're a mysterious people, but their ways make a lot of sense to me. All you have to do is be the best. Doesn't matter if you're born high or low, man or woman. They respect skill, not some fool notion of heritage.
I see the appeal.
I wish more Karja did. Anything they don't understand, they call backward or savage. You ready? Let's trade then. Come on back if you find any Banuk goods. I pay well for Banuk relics, Outlander. Excuse me, Outlander? I'm looking for Banuk artifacts.
Don't just cast about talking to strangers, woman.
Perhaps your travels have taken you through ancient ruins? Let us speak of it.
Here's what I don't get about the sun. These fancy decorations.
Yep.
Maybe one sun call surrenders, it'll be able to feel cold.
This is what peace is like. But what a price we paid.
Some girl applied to the city guard the other day.
Good. I can use this.